Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetfuel.com and today we are going to do a hands-on review of the ZTE Nubia Z5S. So this is the Z5 LTE device which we have with us. Again, this will come to India either in the LTE version or in the non-LTE version as well. So talking about this device in terms of the overall look and feel, first of all, I would like to tell you that this phone is really light in weight. It is very handy. You can easily hold this device in one hand. As far as the display is concerned, the display which we have on this device is a 5-inch display at which you have a full high definition resolution of 1080 into 1920 and you have a pixel density of 441 pixels per inch. As you can see, this device looks fairly slim as well at a thickness of around 7.6 millimeter, which again makes it pretty slim. You have a nice silver lining on the edges which does make it look premium. So the device is definitely looking very good in terms of the look and feel. The back side of the device is actually glossy and again the back cover cannot be removed. This is a unibody device, the battery cannot come out. As far as the weight is concerned, the weight of the device is around 126 grams and it is fairly light in weight to hold it in one hand. As far as the other things of the device is concerned, it has got IGZO capacitive touchscreen display. As you can see, this is how the display looks like, and again the display has pretty good viewing angles as well. You can see the screen from extreme angles without any issues, and the overall display brightness, the colors as well are also looking pretty good on this device. ZTE is going to launch this phone in India approximately in April or May, and we will cover it once it is launched. As far as other things are concerned, this device comes in 16GB, 32GB version, and you have 2GB of RAM on this device. As far as the chipset or the hardware is concerned, it has got a Snapdragon 800 chipset, the Qualcomm Snapdragon 800 chipset, and considering that chipset, this device is the lightest and the thinnest in terms of the thickness of which we have seen so far. You have got quad-core 2.3 GHz processor, Cariot 400 cores, and you have Adreno 330 as the GPU. If we take a look over the front, we have the nice metallic earpiece, we have the proximity and ambient light sensors. When it comes to the camera, the front camera is a 5-megapixel camera, fixed focus. The rear camera is a 13-megapixel camera with this red lining, which actually looks very good. And you have optical image stabilization as well within this camera, and we will just demo you that. You have LED flash as well. On this side, you have the power and sleep key. On the top, you have the 3.5mm audio jack. Over here, you have the IR blaster. You have a SIM card tray slot. You have secondary microphone for noise cancellation and video chat. Over here on the back side, on the bottom, you have dual loudspeakers at the back side. And you have the dedicated camera shutter key as well. At the bottom, you have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging. And you have a primary microphone hole over here. And the home button is a touch capacitive button, as you can see. So this is the touch capacitive button which we have on this device. And again, it actually gives you a different functionality. So this is the normal home button, as you can see. Whenever you are going across the front home screen, you just press it and it will work like a home button. So in all, in terms of the overall design and the form factor, this device is good. On the front, you have Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection as well. The display is 5-inch, and when it comes to the version of Android, it is running Android 4.2.2. When we take a look over the settings, as you can see, once we go under the settings, if we take a look over the about phone, it has got Android 4.2.2. And once we go out, and if we take a look over the storage scenario, so on the storage front, this device has 32GB of internal storage, out of which around 20.91 GB is available to the user. When we take a look over other things on the device, if we talk about the lock screen, okay, not the lock screen where we just come out. So again, you do have some buttons over here, which will again take you back. When it comes to the app scenario, you have 2GB of RAM on this device, and let me just take a look how much of that is actually free. So as of now, on this device specifically, on the running RAM, let me just show you the running processes. So it has like 2GB of RAM, and right now 640 MB of RAM is being used, whereas 1.2 GB of RAM is free. So this device definitely looks quite promising in terms of the overall features. You can also do 4K video recording as well, and 120 FPS high speed video recording is also possible. So this device looks very much promising in terms of the overall specs it has got. When we talk about the other things, it has accelerometer sensor, compass sensor. You can record high definition video at 1080p at 720p as well. And from the front camera, you can record high definition video at 720p. And when we talk about the applications, it does not have any app drawer. But again, this is how the phone dialer looks like. The phone dialer does not not have the option of making a video call when it comes to the messaging application. Let me just go and compose a new message. So once you compose a new message, you have the option of either going to the QWERTY keyboard or you can actually have the 3:4 keyboard. So the overall display size of this device is such that the keyboard typing should not be an issue. So let's find out the camera finally. How does the camera actually perform on this device? So we have our iPhone 5 as of now, and let me just launch the camera so that we can test the camera performance as of now. And we have some artificial light as of now in the area where we are taking photos. And one thing which is good about this device is that it allows you to actually change the focus point, and you can actually do a lot more within this camera UI, which is the major highlight of this device as far as camera is concerned. No other device will actually allow you to do all this, which you can do with this one. So this is how the front camera UI looks like. Looks pretty good. The kind of video feed which we have is kind of high definition, so you can do a high definition video chat from the front camera. As far as the rear camera is concerned, the rear camera does have autofocus and a tap to focus system. Let me just take this photo. So once we have taken this photo, let me just show you the same. This photo, as of now, as you can see, the display was actually going dim. So let me just take it again. So if I just take it again, if I go to the camera again, wait, let me just go to the camera again. Okay, you do have focus now. And now we have taken this photo, let me just preview this for you. So this is how the photo looks like. The photo looks pretty good, I would say, in terms of the clarity. There is no problem with the clarity. The colors, however, are not that great. As you can see, you can compare it with the actual object over there. The colors does not come out to be pretty good or not very impressive as of now. But still, we will do a detailed review once this device comes to India. That's all from us. Thanks for watching this video. You can like this video. If this video helped you, by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.